Let's talk about another way in which we don't have democracy in the United States. I never voted for the filibuster, nor did I vote for the Senate parliamentarian, nor the rules on which kind of legislation must go through budget reconciliation, nor any other rule that allows corporate prostitutes to thwart the will of the people, or even completely shut down the government. Of course, because the United States is a representative democracy rather than a direct democracy, we the people shouldn't expect to be consulted on every matter of congressional procedure. And that's fine. But the founders made a huge mistake in leaving such things entirely to the discretion of the Congress rather than writing some guidelines into the Constitution. It's not as though the founders were entirely ignorant. They knew that politicians will game the system whenever it suits their purposes. The filibuster wasn't invented in 19th century America. Julius Caesar's opponents used it. Caesar accepted and played their game, just as America's founders accepted the filibuster in particular and a gameable system in general, taking as given that government will not always govern, but will spend quite a bit of time mired in political and procedural games and getting nothing done. The founders learned many things from the study of governments throughout history, but one thing they didn't learn is that it's a mistake to hope for politicians to be mostly people of good will who act in good faith, for the good of the people, the good of the nation, rather than for self-interest. Unsurprisingly, the founders took a view similar to that of religious people. Humans are fallen creatures, and we must hope for government to attract humans who are trying to be good, in great enough numbers, and with great enough political will, to overpower those who would act in bad faith. It would have made much more sense to accept humans as we are, and rather than naively hoping for good will and good faith, to construct a system in which it's much, much harder, more risky, and less profitable to be corrupt. But that didn't happen, and now we have a mostly stagnant government, paralyzed by bad faith actors gaming the system to thwart the will of the people. By definition, we don't have a democracy.